Thank you. Have a nice evening.
Next on Late Night with David Letterman, actor Robert Duvall and the Gypsy discuss the film Angelo, My Love. Weeknights, go where the news is. Watch NBC Nightly News with Roger Mudd and Tom Brokaw.
Friday on Bare Essence, Nico survives a murder attempt, but now it's his manhood that's threatened.
It's not a sign of weakness.
Well, all Sean needs is...
exercise.
Tuesday, he's the sexiest, smoothest private eye around. Who but Remington Steele would dare to follow the A-team?
I'm a man who enjoys impossible challenges.
Your next car has to last a long time. You've got to make the right choice. Thousands of dollars are at stake.
Right.
The experts say the right choice is at your Toyota dealer. Celica is a winner. Exceptional quality. Corolla, well-built, reliable, economical. Cressida, smooth and sure, a quality car throughout. Toyota four-wheel drive, a bargain.
Right.
The right choice at your Toyota dealers now. Your Toyota dealers got it right.
Today, take your first step into a bright new world of investment opportunity and financial security. Let Prudential-Bache introduce you to Total Financial Planning, a lifetime strategy to properly place your investment assets for maximum returns. Total Financial Planning, the only sensible course of action for the uncertain 80s, and we offer it to you. Call us now. Prudential-Bache Securities. Bring us your future.
Bring us your future.
John M. Smith is moving from their shopping center locations, and their great inventory reduction sale is in its final days. But the selection is still tremendous. Millions of dollars of fine quality furniture is now reduced 35 to 70% to close out this great sale. So hurry to the Smith store nearest you today and save up to 70% or more on top quality furniture by America's most famous makers. But hurry, this great sale is in its final days now at the John M. Smith store nearest you.
Channel 5 News covers the inauguration of Harold Washington live Friday at 2.
Awfully darn nice of you folks. Welcome to the program. I sense that we have some people here visiting from out of town, and let me announce to you and to the rest of the citizens of this great land of ours, and by that, of course, I mean the United States of America, that here in New York, we are celebrating Crime Awareness Week, and this is the annual week that we set aside to pay tribute to the city's leading industry, and we're all very... Awareness Week. We got a good good program. This is, are you excited?
Yeah!
I said excited, not under the influence. Good heavens. One of the finest working actors in the world is here tonight, Robert Duvall. And he has directed a new motion picture entitled Angelo, My Love, and a gentleman who is an actor and also a gypsy. This, I believe, is the first time we have had this introduction. Is an actor gypsy on the program? Steve Tsiginoff is here, also from that motion picture. And we're on late tonight, aren't we? We're on a little late. The President of the United States is trying to straighten out this John Elway mess, so he... what is the deal? Do we want him now playing for the Yankees, or are we just... We do. We're not upset with his attitude or anything, are we? Okay, well, and then the Jets drafted a pretty good, who was the guy's name from UC Davis? A football power in its own right. What was his name?
Ken Brian?
Ken Bryan?
Ken O'Brien.
Ken O'Brien, correct. What do we got for him, Bill?
A brand new car!
That's right. yes, I'm Alex Trebek, and this is Sale of the Century. We're going to put you in a new mobile home tonight, so stay tuned. So how much later are we on? An hour later? Oh, heaven. Oh. Yeah, that's it. Let's walk. We don't need to take this crap. Let's go. half an hour later. Anyway, and a man's applauding for the half hour. It's just... a woman who was here last night, sort of, but is back again tonight. The Playmate of the Year, ladies and gentlemen, Marianne Gravatte. And this would be worth standing up for. I would, even despite the fact that we're a half an hour late, you want to get a look at this woman. That's an awful thing to say, isn't it? I'm sorry I said that. But heavens, she's in that magazine naked, so what do we care? In fact, she's in the hallway naked. Let's go. You can't take her anywhere. She undresses at the drop of a hat, so... Sorry, I'm sorry I brought it up. Another installment, maybe, of Know Your Staff. Tonight, film coordinator Rick Scheckman, ladies and gentlemen. That, of course, explains the extra security in the lobby. Now, and finally, a visit to shoe repair windows of New York City. Now, let's talk to our good friend, Mr. Paul Shaffer, right there.
Hey, I want to tell you, thank you so much. I'm excited about Marianne Gravatte. You know, my picture was in Playboy last month.
That's right, you were in Playboy.
I wanted to make an announcement about it. There is no airbrushing in that picture of me. That is the way I am.
Oh, well, that's
my body. That's the way it is.
That's doubly exciting. Nice to see you again, Paul. And Paul, and of course, Hiram Bullock, and Will Lee, and Steve Jordan. Our band.
Aren't they wild? I think they're kind of wild, this band.
Yeah?
Don't you
think
so? They're wild.
They are wild. They're the party boys of rock and roll, aren't they?
You christened them that, yes.
That's right. Tonight is Thursday, and every Thursday since we've been on the air since the late 50s, we've been answering our viewer mail, and we're kind of proud of that tradition here, although we don't know why, and tonight is certainly no exception. So our first letter, ladies and gentlemen, if I may be so bold as to suggest some guests, well, this is a helpful letter, and we appreciate it. The guest suggestions are Julius Irving, Joan Collins, Deborah Jensen, Solid Gold Dancer, Billy Joel, Farrah Fawcett, Olivia Newton-John, Rich Hall, Leon Redbone, Christopher Lloyd, John Updike, Muhammad Ali, Keith Lee, Rush, Thomas Hearns, Vita Blue, Larry Brown, the ex-Redskin running back, Kim Alexis, Clint Eastwood, and Michael Caine. Signed, Tony Barker. Gee, Tony, this letter comes to us a little late. Apparently, you missed last Tuesday's show. Let's take a look at how that was last Tuesday. Tony, once again, I'm sorry you missed it. I don't know whether that was more silly or longer, never mind. Letter number two. Dear David, Hinky? Sincerely, Gwen Hartley. Dear Gwen, Hartley? Letter number three. That was Steve Jordan with the amazing poultry-like cackle over in the corner, ladies and gentlemen. Dear Dave, I have been watching your show since it went on the air way back in the late 50s. I love that crashing sound when you throw things out of the window behind your desk. Dave, tell me, does the crew know beforehand that you are going to toss something, or do you have a special button hooked up to your desk? I am dying to know, Dave. Tell us all. Well, obviously, you realize, of course, that there is no window behind me. Let me just show you. There's nothing here. That would be too expensive. It's all done with special effects, and what the woman is referring to is, I'll pick up a pencil like this, and you hear that noise. Now, what we'll do now is we'll show you how that effect is created. So if everybody is ready, are we all ready? Okay, here we go. All right, there you go. That was our own Tommy Casabono. I still have mice, by the way, and I don't know how to get rid of them. I've tried the shotgun. It seems inefficient, but... sometimes we have too much fun here at the Playhouse, and... Dear Mr. Letterman, some sort of a drill going on here. This letter concerns the cigarette butt that... The This letter concerns the cigarette butt that was found on your studio floor tonight, as well as a couple of months ago. I cannot imagine something like this happening on network television once, let alone twice. Are you sure you don't pay someone to litter your studio just so you can waste a few minutes talking about it? Sincerely, Mike McGuire, Kamloops, British Columbia. Kamloops is not unlike a breakfast cereal. Well, Mike, I didn't think that I paid someone to litter the studio, and then one night I was watching the closing credits of this program, and boy, was I in for a surprise. Take a look at what I saw, and I... Finally, dear Mr. Letterman, I wish to correct a statement made by you on your March 29th program. The ducks do not return north in the latter part of March. They will officially return to this area in the second week of April. If you will recall, I am a New Jersey duck warden in Bergen County and have written to you before about the exploitation of the duck on your show. If you must ridicule waterfowl, Mr. Letterman, at least get your facts straight. Yours sincerely, J.V. Cubby, Fairlawn, New Jersey. Well, Mr. Cubby, I certainly remember your other letter, and we don't want to mislead the public about migration habits. And like you said, the ducks return in early April, and there's one right over there. And but, Mr. Cubby, you conveniently forgot one other fact, that in late April, you yourself fly north.
County. I'm an important public official. Give me some room. Stop your gawking. Damn it, I'm just trying to do the job I was elected to do. What are you staring at? Go back to your home. There's nothing more to be seen here.
Well, at least no one was hurt. We have a fine program for you folks. Mr. Robert Duvall will be joining us right after you take a look at that.
Miss Sears Spring Home Sale for sensational savings. Save $130 on this powerful canister vacuum with beater bar brush. $100 on this Kenmore microwave with probe. This VCR with visual search and freeze frame, $399.95. This 18 cubic foot frostless refrigerator, just $499.95. Save on this Kenmore washer, now $299.95. This matching dryer, only $239.95, both with permanent press cycle. So hurry to the Spring Home Sale at Sears.
Fragrance created by Gloria Vanderbilt. Vanderbilt, a rich, expressive fragrance that reveals to the world just how splendid you are. Vanderbilt, let it release the splendor of you. Vanderbilt.
It is hot. It is a 1983 Firebird from your Chicagoland Pontiac dealers. What do you think a legend like this costs? $12,000, $14,000, $16,000? Think again. Brand new 83 Firebird prices start at just $88.13. Just $88.13. Fire one up today. And for more savings, get details on brand new, low 9.9% GMAC financing. Now available on selected Pontiacs at your Chicagoland, Northwestern Indiana Pontiac dealers.
For international cuisine or down-home cooking, count on Jewel. Create a perfect pizza with contadina tomato sauce. 4 8-ounce cans are only $1. Or make another Italian favorite with contadina tomato paste. 3 6-ounce cans are only $1. Now for all-American cooking, try fried chicken made with Jewel whole fryers. Only 39 cents a pound. For menus everybody loves, save through Wednesday at Jewel.
Hi there, America, and welcome Welcome back to the program. My first guest is often called one of the finest actors in America, and he has acted in such films as, this is an unbelievable list, To Kill a Mockingbird, the motion picture MASH, The Godfather, Network, Apocalypse Now, The Great Santini, the recently released Tender Mercies, and he is also a writer and director, and his most recent release, Angelo, My Love, opened this week to great reviews. Please welcome Mr. Robert Duvall.
Pleasure to meet you, sir.
I think one of my cameramen.
It's nice, isn't it?
Yeah, that's
good. You don't get to hear that when you're making a film, but you come out and do something like this.
Right.
And
you have to go to back to the stage, which I don't do that often to get that. You know, on a good night that happens.
It's a pleasure to meet you, and I appreciate you coming by. And well, congratulations on this film.
Thank you for having me.
Great review this morning in the Times.
Yeah, wonderful.
Yeah. Now this is Angelo, My Love, about gypsies.
Yes.
Tell us, you worked with these people for a long time now, so tell us about them.
Well, I met a kid, a little boy, and as soon as I met the kid, I figured this kid should be the lead in a movie. What he said that day and how he behaved dictated the next 5 years of my life, really. And in order to do my homework, to know what I was doing, I had to get to know gypsies all over America, and they're basically a very interesting, vibrant group of people that live outside the mainstream. And Angelo kind of represents to me what gypsies are supposed to mean to us. Very deep, very magnetic, very charismatic, and very talented. And they're very interesting people, and they were wonderful natural actors, and it was wonderful working with them, really.
Tell them who Angelo is, and then recreate the meeting you had with him,
well,
or how you met him.
Yeah, Angelo is a young gypsy boy. He lives in New Jersey now. He was 7 years old when I first met him. He was standing at 71st and Columbus, where I lived at the time, talking to Patricia Panarella, a woman of 25, and with great conviction, he said, "Patricia, if you don't love me no more, I'm going to move to Cincinnati." And he said it with such conviction that that I decided at that moment that I wanted to make a film with him as the lead. And when we first started to progress and get it to a point where we could shoot, when we get ready to shoot, he's like any other actor, a potential actor. He said, "Bobby," he says, "if I don't win an Academy Award for this, I'm going to tear my hair out." So he's quite something, man.
The term gypsy, does that mean a group of people who have their heritage in one part of Europe or another? I mean, what specifically makes a person?
Well, what I understand, of course, even gypsies may disagree with me on this. Gypsies come from India 1,000 years ago, and they settled in Europe, various countries, and eventually came to this country. And what denotes a gypsy to me is that they all speak the Romanesque language. So a gypsy from New Jersey or New York or California went to Russia or Spain or France, they could converse with a gypsy of that country because of that language, that common denominator, really.
Now, I think the what comes to mind is probably a negative image of a gypsy.
How do you mean
accurate? That a gypsy might come into town and take advantage of a group of old people and then move on. Now, is that...
Well, I don't know. There are many different tests. If you ask a gypsy a question, you get 20 different answers. So if you ask that question, you get 20 different answers.
Uh-huh.
If you ask me, you'll get a number of answers. All I can say is I worked with them for 5 or 6 years. There were a lot of problems on a daily basis, but...
Like what? What would be a problem for you?
Well, they just would like to play head... Nothing serious, just play head game. You know, like, Angelo called me up once. He said, "I've been going to school." I said, "Well, who's in your class?" He named this kid who sat here, this kid sat here. And all of a sudden he started laughing and said, "I bet my father $5 I could tell you a lie that you'd believe."
Yeah.
And I believed it.
Yeah.
So they like to play games, but it's in the work condition, it that all served in a positive way, in that kind of identity that they have and the way they operate on these levels, however they do it, was wonderful for the film in bringing a certain truth and a certain energy.
Well, when you see the film, it's like watching people literally on another planet, because the style of life is very,
very
unusual.
And I never said, except for scenes like Hollywood when you're running down the street, I never used the word action.
Mm-hmm.
I didn't want it to be like, now we're here, now we begin. It was always just, it's all the same.
Yeah.
So I said, no acting. That's what I always tried to stress, to keep it as lifelike as possible, really.
But you, again, watching the film, you do get a sense that if this is an accurate reflection of their life, that there is some sort of code of honor by which they're operating.
Oh, yeah, they have their own, you know, set of ethics. They have their own courts.
Yeah.
They have their own marriages. They have their own divorces. They have, you know, all the tribal customs that are really much different from ours.
How many would you say are in this country?
I've heard anywhere between 20,000 to 500,000. Yeah. So once again, it's hard to get an absolute answer because I to me, gypsies make up their absolutes on a daily basis. So it's hard to pin down and get absolute answers on things.
Yeah. Are they making a lot of money as gypsies? I mean, I
don't. Some do, some don't, I guess. It's like anybody. It's like some do, some don't. And I know Potalite is coming out in a little while. He's not particularly affluent at all. Others are.
Okay, we're going to show a piece of the film just recently, I guess today or yesterday released, Angelo, My Love.
Yeah, noontime today it came out.
And
I think some of the crew is in the audience.
Steve, oh, really?
Mack. Steve Mack, wonderful editor, Barry Markowitz, assistant cameraman.
Okay, and these guys are not gypsies, or are they?
No, not yet.
Okay. Robert, do you know what we're going to look at here? You want to tell the folks about this?
Well, I think it's a schoolroom scene. You know, Angelo once said to me, if you put a schoolroom scene in the film, I will not do the film.
Yeah.
But I wanted to see a gypsy boy in a situation where he was forced to go to school. And at the point where he could not read in fiction, it was also reality at that moment. So reality served fiction at that moment.
So,
and I wanted to have a scene where he was struggling and was out of his element in a schoolroom situation. So we filmed this scene, and we put it in the editing up front. We decided because to show something of him.
Yeah.
Within the American culture before we get into the storyline, so to speak.
Okay, that will be Angelo, the star of Angelo, My Love, and recently released Robert Duvall motion picture.
Well, there was this African guy, and he made a hole in the rock, and the monkey seen because he put the seeds in the rock. So the monkey got off the tree and got his hand stuck in the rock. So the man came, wrapped him around with the rope.
Where are you?
Put him on a tree.
Angelo,
hold it.
You're supposed to read what's on this page.
What?
You're supposed to read the words that are on that page.
Like what? What does it say there? There, monkey.
You're supposed to read the story that's on this page. You're
making I forgot my glasses. What do you want me to do?
You forgot your glasses?
Yes.
You wear glasses?
Yes, I do.
So you can't read without your glasses?
I can.
Are you farsighted or nearsighted?
Every side.
You're every sided?
Angelo, my love. We have to go away for a commercial. We'll be right back to continue talking about this.
What's this? Dirt sneaking into the Eureka vacuum cleaner factory, home of the powerful Mighty Mite, two motor power teams, and ESP uprights with extra suction power. Is America's valiant force against deep down hidden dirt to be the victim of a dirty deed? No. Eureka gets dirt you can't see.
You know, I've always wanted an Amana.
I've always wanted an Amana sale.
I've always wanted an Amana. I've always wanted an Amana sale.
And now for all those people who've always wanted an Amana. Amana announces great savings on radar range ovens, refrigerators, freezers, and much more. So head on down to your Amana dealer and beat the crowd.
Guess we better head on in.
Yeah, beat the crowd.
Yeah.
The I've always wanted an Amana sale. Now at participating Amana dealers.
The new Nissan 4x4 has loads more than the competition, with the most powerful standard engine in its class. More leg room than Ford Ranger, Chevy S10, and Toyota. Tough double steel walls, plus on-demand four-wheel drive you can't get on Toyota. Want more? Then get more. The new Nissan 4x4. It's loaded.
All this, and special 9.9% financing. See your all-American Metro Dotson dealers. They're driven to save you money.
Huh?
abundanza. Lots of topping.
Oh, mama, that's what I like.
Lots and lots of topping on every slice. So less cancer sauce, that's so, so nice. A tasty crust that's crisp and light.
Abundanza.
Celeste has lots of topping. Lots of topping. That's
abundanza.
Yeah. There's nothing that'll feed you like the abundanza pizza. You'll agree. It's easy to see why.
Woohoo, mama, that's what I like.
Hi there. Robert Duvall is here. And we're going to meet another one of the stars of the motion picture, Angelo, My Love, in a couple of minutes. But first of all, you're looking at the kid there. He was, what you said, yeah. Seven. You get the feeling that he's evolved way beyond what your average seven-year-old kid may ever achieve, huh?
Right. He was always very close. Somebody saw him and says, when you see a kid this young that knows so much, you got to believe in reincarnation. Mm. Actually, this scene where he's reading, we had 5 minutes to get the bulk of the scene, and we didn't know how to get it because we were losing 35 kid extras. Uh-huh. And so finally we said, well, just read that joke you've been telling the crew all morning. So his feigning reading was he was a reading a joke that Barry Markowitz gave to him to, so that was his text, so to speak.
Does he read it
quick,
all?
Very quick.
Angelo?
Some. Yeah. Not a lot. He's been going to school, but he doesn't.
How about the rest of the gypsies? Did they read?
Well, many do, some don't. But in filming, it was much more comfortable to deal with them, you know, without a script, although we had one. To just deal with a spoken word, because there's no written language, and everything that's passed down from century to century is done through the spoken word. Yeah. So they feel more at ease with that.
There's one scene in there, and this is silly to talk about it until people see it, but I'll do it anyway. It's my show. the trial scene, the first trial, is so powerful that you get the feeling that you're actually it's actually a documentary. You know, it looks like it's actually.
But it
occurring.
Is fiction. Yeah. I said, I want this, and this. And they said, we don't want to practice, just roll a camera.
Yeah, it was amazing.
I mean, and then one scene where Frankie gets mad and wants, you know, to clear his name. My wife, Gail Youngs, who was a producer, was coming back on a plane with Bob De Niro and said, you got to see this guy go into a fitness courtroom. That's difficult for an actor to do. Yeah. But he said, I wanted to go home. I knew I couldn't, so I used that. I got mad. It's like a method actor or something.
It was very impressive. How did you cast these folks? How did the word go out that you needed 40 gypsies?
Well, I had the principal pay, and then a lot of people came, and like, if this guy couldn't do it, then all of a sudden I got this guy, and then his wife got sick, so I said, well, you do it. And he was as good as the first guy, and we never rehearsed. Mm-hmm. So it was just you would pick guys like this.
From all over the country?
Yeah. Stevie came from California, mostly from New York. Yeah. A lot of Russian gypsies from Brooklyn, Jimmy Italiano and his people over from near Coney Island. We had Argentine gypsies, we had Russian, Yugoslav, Greek, Canadian gypsies all in the film from all over.
These nice people?
Yeah, we got along. We, you know, we had problems like any movie set, but, you know, it was a very exciting, creative experience, really.
How much did you pay them?
In the neighborhood of $150 a day. I mean, everybody got paid the same, and it paid them at the end of the day and at the end of the week.
Yeah.
Because, you know, I don't know who's going to show up. If they would, they wouldn't. You know, it's like... So we pay at the end of the day.
All right, we're gonna meet one of your stars and an actual gypsy. I believe this man is the first gypsy we've had on this program in over a year. We have to go away for station identification first, then we'll be back to meet Steve Tsiginoff and Robert Duvall. Hello,
Steve.
J.C. Penney unfurls an expose of Hunt Club fashions at Fashion Expo. Sassy shirts and fine-fitting jeans. This all-over cotton never misses a beat. So show off in big, bad stripes. Or play it cool in solid style. But get them for $20 each before the expo's over. Hunt Club at J.C. Penney.
Open wide.
Oh, wait a minute, Doctor.
What's wrong, Joan?
You need the breath deodorant.
Sorry. Must have been the onion salad dressing.
Clorets will take care of that.
Clorets?
Clorets is the breath deodorant. It'll freshen your breath fast. Only Clorets has Actizol and helps your mouth's own freshening power eliminate bad breath. The breath deodorant costs a little more, but it's worth it. Ready, Doctor.
For fresh breath fast, Clorets, the breath deodorant.
Right now could be the best time to make your best deal on an 83 Toyota truck.
Your Toyota dealer's got 14 tough models. Every one is the same price as the 82s, except diesel, its price went down. The Toyota Standard Truck, the lowest priced Toyota truck, has the same powerful gas engine, three across seating, same big payload as Toyota's other two buys. Don't let your Toyota truck get away. Make your deal now. Your Toyota dealer's got it right.
Haunting, mysterious, sensual, strange, perverse, riveting. The Hunger.
Life signs terminate right here.
The Hunger, a modern classic of perverse fear. The Hunger, rated R.
Starts tomorrow at a theater near you. Check newspapers.
Sunday, it's the night all America's waited for. TV Guide's Judith Chris says, an imaginative first-class thriller. The Washington Post says, an eye-popping adventure. Action-packed enough for kids, serious enough for adults. The television event of the season. The Visitors are coming Sunday on NBC.
Johnny, in the morning, Luke, that is.
Yeah, I know you think it's him, don't you? But it ain't, it's me. That's right, you better be listening to me on the radio. 98 FM, The Loop, I'm Mr. B, I'll bust the radio. You got that?
Channel 5 pioneered the first financial reports on Chicago TV. Now, watch Mike Jackson's new Money Watch. Not only CDs, prime rates, inflation, and gold, but also jobs, prices, Chicago business. Information that helps you manage your life better. Financial reports you can take to the bank. Money Watch, 4:30 on Channel 5 News.
I'm confused with all those ads on TV. I don't know where to get my muffler fixed.
Don't be confused. Take your car to a Fair muffler shop. When you bring your car to Fair, they'll show you what's wrong and what needs to be replaced, and you'll know how much it's going to cost before they fix your car.
Exhaust pipe and tailpipe are okay. All you need is a muffler, and your car will sound just like new.
Inspections are free and the service is terrific. Call Fair and compare.
I'm not confused anymore. Fair Mufflers is the place to go.
Their name says it all.
Your better Buick dealers are about to make those front-wheel drive imports take a back seat with three front-wheel drive Buicks and a price under $7,000. For sporty car lovers, there's Buick's racy Skyhawk. For economy and comfort, there's the roomy Buick Skylark. And for sleek luxury, there's Buick's little limousine, Century. Now you can enter the world of front-wheel drive for as little as $69.58 at your Chicagoland, Northern Indiana better Buick dealer.
Join us for entertainment tonight at 3:30 here on Channel 5.
At the time, I didn't know. I don't think so now. Welcome back to the show, and thank you, boys. By the way, you passed the audition. Very nice. Tomorrow night on this program, we have, one of our special 90-minute programs. And once again, it doesn't seem longer, ladies and gentlemen. It is longer. Jane Curtin will be here from SCTV, Mr. Martin Short, dancers from the Rocksteady crew, Stupid Petrix, Marv Albert, and the list goes on and on. We have dozens and dozens of people for you tomorrow night. Robert, tell us about how you met the gentleman who plays Padelet in your film.
Well, Stevie was, Francis Ford Coppola called him a great actor. He said, where'd you find him? And I said, I found him shining up cars at Schwab's drugstore in Los Angeles, mm-hmm. where all the unemployed actors go. And once he got a part, then the unemployed actors asked him if there was a part in there for them, you see. But he became kind of...
Had he done any acting that you know
No,
before?
But he used to be a drummer way back years ago mm-hmm. with Stan Getz, and he's his whole family were entertainers in Russia. Their father had played for the Tsar in Russia, an accordionist.
And an actual gypsy.
Oh, they're Russian gypsies.
Yeah.
Tsiginoff means gypsy family uh-huh. in Russian.
And the bad guy in your film.
Yeah, he's a bad guy, but you don't really know that for sure.
Yeah. That's right.
Great guy.
Let's bring him out here now, ladies and gentlemen, one of the stars of Angelo, My Love, Steve Tsiginoff.
Steve, how are you? Nice to see you, sir. Have a seat.
Steve, is what Robert said about your meeting at Schwab's, is that pretty much the deal?
Well, I was at Schwab's drugstore, and I was polishing a friend of mine's car.
Uh-huh.
So, at that day, I didn't make any money. I'm a little broke. No cigarettes, no
coffee. How normally would you be making money?
Body work. Yeah. And that's normal.
You mean on cars?
On cars, yeah.
Yeah.
So, this guy comes over to me and says, "Hey, Steve, Robert Duvall wants to see you." Robert Duvall wants to see me? He said, "Yeah, come on, he's around the corner over there, he wants to see you." Listen, I didn't have no cigarettes or coffee. I got no money. I'm hungry. He better be there. Sure enough, I meet this gentleman, and we've been friends for quite some time, and he approached me, and he asked me if I wanted to do the movie. So I said, yes. he says, "Do you do anything else?" Yes, I do a little impressions, but only for myself, for my friends, things like that.
You do impressions?
Oh, yeah. I do.
He went backstage for Claude Rains in the 40s and did Claude Rains in The Invisible Man. Backstage for Claude Rains.
That was about 55.
Now, do you want to do a little of that now, Steve, or?
With your permission, I'd like to do The Invisible Man. It's 1933 going back. But the man had such a great voice, you know, that I fell in love with the man's voice. So I learned it and I practiced it.
Okay.
So I'm going to set a scene. It won't take long. It's he's walking into this pub. As a snowstorm is really ridiculous. And he walks in and he approaches the table and the innkeeper says, which was E.E. Clive. Maybe you remember him.
No, I don't know.
An English gentleman, a fine actor. "Here now, Governor. What can I do for you?" Says, "I'd like to have a room, and I want to be alone. I have a great deal of experiments. You hear me? Leave me alone. I want a room now." "All right, Governor, don't get your hopes all locked up."
In the motion picture, you are portrayed as a guy doing a lot of nasty stuff, stealing. Now, the things I've been saying out here about gypsies, by way of questions, would any of those things offend gypsies, or?
Well, if they don't understand what's happening, you know what I mean? Like, they should be proud that they are being mentioned, because many gypsies are diminishing.
Yeah.
You know, so they're not too recognized. As soon as somebody hears the word gypsy, "Hey, here goes my wallet."
But in the film, it looks like everybody's working a con. Little Angelo is always doing something, and they're fortune-telling and so forth. Is that true?
That's the only way they make a living, by telling fortunes.
Now, is there...
Doing body work. On cars.
Telling fortunes or body work. It's similar skills.
Some of them are entertainers. Some of them I was an entertainer. I used to play drums, but I developed asthma, so I can't play them no more.
This is fascinating stuff. But before we continue talking about how gypsies make a living, let's show the folks what you're doing in this film. Do you know about the scene?
No,
we're gonna
not
see your
the
scene?
The scene is the trial scene has just been finished, and Steve's side of the family wins. It's kind of a rigged trial.
Yeah.
And he's very happy to get a family heirloom back that was stolen from his family 3 generations ago. So he got it back for his family, from Angelo's family. And his sister, Millie, comes in to find out what happened, because she's late, as she always is, for the trial. So they meet in a bar where the trial was held after the trial is over. This is the first meeting where we see her in the film.
It's a good scene.
Yeah. Now, the trial is also a great scene. But this is all actually your sister, isn't it, Millie?
Yeah, Millie. Yeah. Oh, she just had a stroke.
She doing all right?
She doing better.
She's coming along.
Okay, all right. So that's what we're going to take a look at here, again, from the motion picture, Angelo, my love, Steve Tsiginoff, and his sister, Millie.
Yeah, well, everything went well.
Yeah.
Nice double.
Big Bob saved me.
Nice double. What's this?
What's what?
What's this?
What's it look like?
Whiskey.
That's what it is.
You're not supposed to touch that anymore. You know that.
Uh-huh.
So, look, Stevie. Now my pigachia. You heard the doctor. If you're going to start drinking again, you're going to die.
Such as my best, I said, list you down. Then I come for today. We might have to leave in a couple of days. You're in the Canada.
Yeah, I'll put it away.
I got to go. Not going to settle.
Marge, we'll have two corks, please.
This will never settle anything.
I appreciate it.
Nothing. I am good woman in Canada. Good to see you.
Big deal. All right.
You never have.
Leave me alone.
Yeah. I'll leave you alone. I'll leave you alone. You got another room. I'll leave you alone for good.
I don't need nobody no more.
Because you never need anybody. You're not good by yourself, and you know that.
I'm all right.
You always need me. So why don't you keep
quiet?
You're
not here when I need you anyway.
Yeah, I was waiting for you. I'll call you, Mila. I'll call you, and you never call. Then you start blaming me for everything.
Take your door off. There's people here.
Oh, take I beg your pardon. That's mine. No, that's mine. You alcoholic crook. You're always chiseling something. Hey? You know what I went through in the hospital for you? Yeah. Can't you ever listen for a change?
How did you and everybody else in this film who had not acted before know how to do that? How many times did it take you to get that scene?
Not maybe a couple of takes.
Yeah.
That's about all. But you see, like Mr. Duvall says, I have an acting ability. I'm not an actor. I never acted before in my life. I guess it's being streetwise.
Yeah.
You learn to talk this way and to react with your head because, you know, you have to learn how to survive on the streets.
How have the other other gypsies that you know reacted to this film? You had a screening for some, all right?
I haven't seen too many. We had a screening for about 400 gypsies came, and it was like 3D because the gypsies were on the stage and they were all around you with the vibe.
Yeah.
You know? It was very the energy level was very high. Now whether they liked it or not, verbally afterwards, I don't know. I think they did, but what they experienced and what we felt they experienced during the film, they loved it. I mean, yeah. They went crazy every time someone came on. They knew they laughed. They cheer, and it was hard to hear because of the tremendous response during the screening. Yeah.
Well, actually, if I may say this, the gypsies out there who will see me all know me.
Uh-huh.
I'm known all over the world as Patalai.
Patalai.
Now, I would like to say, and say to you, that these gypsy people who renounce the making of this movie should not renounce it and try to cause any friction because they should feel proud that there's a lot of gypsies out there that aren't known. And this is their opportunity to be known by these people.
Yeah.
And the people out there.
Right.
And they shouldn't feel that way.
And you're still available for body work?
Anytime. And give me that sandpaper and I'm on my way.
Do real quick. When he goes up in a room and it comes in and the invisible man has a bandage on his head and when he takes it off, when they're looking at him, say that real quick.
More invisible man impressions.
More invisible man impressions.
Go, real quick.
Okay.
For the laugh.
So he walks in and he's taking off the bandages. Blimey, look at him. He's all eaten away. Oh, you fools. You unmitigated fools. I'll show you. So you want to see me, hey? Here's a nose for you and an ear for you.
Steve Tsiginoff. Steve, thank you very much.
Thank you very much.
Robert, pleasure meeting you. Congratulations, sir. Robert Duvall. The movie is Angelo, my love. We'll be right back to take a visit to Shoe Repair Shop.
America's favorite place to save cash. Your nearby Datsun dealers. Our economical Sentra costs $499 less than Toyota's Corolla. Buy a Sentra and all this for the same price. Or buy a Sentra and all this worth $1,000 for the price of a Honda Civic. Stretch your dollars even further with our great gas mileage. So when you buy your Sentra, what will you do with all the cash you stash?
You had to ask.
See all the Sentras at your all-American Metro Datsun dealers. They're driven to save you money.
It's Carson's $4 million Gold Fest. 44% off on 14-karat gold chains, bracelets, earrings, and more. Come revel in our elegant selection. With 44% off, the values are incredible. Carson's $4 million Gold Fest. Where the problem isn't buying gold, it's knowing when to stop. For the perfect Mother's Day gift, come to the Gold Fest. Now at Carson Perry Scott & Company.
Every Hoover vacuum is on sale now at Polk Brothers during their fabulous warehouse sale. Get this compact Hoover Quick Broom for fast pickups, only $29.95. This self-propelled Hoover Concept 1 with headlight and attachments is priced just $209.99. And with your Hoover Concept 1 purchase, this Cobra Phone high-tech push-button telephone can be yours for just $4. Now, during the incredible warehouse sale happening at all Polk Brothers stores through May 1st.
They're the talk of the town.
Fantastic. I would come back again to the Gallant Men of Olds.
The used cars from the Gallant Men of Olds. Talk about satisfaction.
More than satisfied with the people that I dealt with. Very happy. I pulled it out of the parking lot and put 24,000 miles on it without a lick of trouble.
See the talk of the town used cars.
I got a great car, great deal, great salesman. Really.
Talk to your Gallant Men of Olds. You'll love what you hear.
Thank you, gentlemen. Very nicely done, as always. Today, of course, here in New York City was the first real day of spring, but there have been signs of it in the better stores all over town. The new spring windows are going up, and we decided to pay a visit to some shoe repair shops here in New York to discuss how they put together those decorative and stylish special spring window displays. Now, if you're planning a visit to New York City, you're probably going to want to take a tour of some kind, and there are a couple you could take, the theater tour, maybe a restaurant tour, perhaps a tour of museums, but a tour that's going to be a lot of fun and very informational is the tour of shoe repair store windows, and this is a good place to start, the Empire Shoe Repair here on Lexington. This is the owner, Enrico. How you doing, Enrico?
All right, you?
Tell me what you know about the window display here. Is this your special spring display?
Yes, that's my old stuff I'm selling inside to the customers.
Do you have a special designer come in and put that up for you?
No, really, it's my old boy who does that. He comes, like, next month, he's gone to school, and he comes to straighten up the window.
Now, next to the suede dye, you have a pencil. Was that his idea?
Well, that's my little boy, which he drew, put the window, and he dropped and he left it there.
He left it in. How often do you change the display in the window here?
Depends. All the time he's off, but a monthly, month and a half. Depends how off is he.
So I guess he's now planning the next display, which would be, what, the 4th of July window?
Oh, will be now in the middle of this month.
Middle of next month. Well, we'll certainly be happy to come back and take a look at that one. Anything else you can describe to us in the window there? You have your shoelaces next to the odor eaters. The shoe trees are always nice, aren't they?
Yeah.
I guess that would be, regardless of the season, you'd have shoe trees, huh? Well, it's a lovely window. I appreciate your help.
Not bad.
Thank you very much, Enrico.
You're welcome.
This is another stop on our tour of shoe repair shop window arrangements. This is the Manhattan Shoe Repair Shop at 55th and 2nd Avenue. This is Harry Papadopoulos. Harry, what can you tell us about the display window here?
Well, it's pretty old. This building is kind of old. And it was, everything is made, is antique.
Do you have somebody come in, a professional designer, and arrange that for you?
No, not quite. I sort of just put some things out myself.
Tell me about the photos you have here on the wall. Who are these people?
Well, I know most of them, except for this one. Lanny Ross, a singer, he's still around. He's very good. And Mr. Lotsworth, and a good friend, Van Johnson. This lady right here is a mystery, sort of. We know she's a singer. And she came in, and she does cabaret work. And then she just disappeared on us. She invited us over once we went, and she disappeared. She never showed up.
That is a mystery.
You can't put everything up.
No, that's true.
You know? Yeah. So we keep the more recent ones, you know, in our house.
Great. Thank you very much, Eric.
You're welcome.
This is the College Shoe Repair Shop at 53rd in Lexington, and your name is?
Markidis.
Sir, I wonder if you could describe for us the window display here in the shoe repair store.
Well, it looks like it was a shoe repair. Some people come in to fix the shoes and everything.
How often do you change the window?
Oh. I wash in the windows only. I have the same all the time.
And these giant, colorful things up there, what are those?
Shoehorn, to put on the shoe horn, right?
Yeah. Okay, and then what is this one right here? I've never seen that.
This is shoe stretchers. You're stretching the shoe.
Yeah. Well, you've certainly run the gamut as far as shoe repair is concerned, haven't you?
Huh?
That's right. Thank you very much.
You're welcome.
Well, that concludes our tour of the shoe repair shop windows of New York City, and It's been a full day for me. Just a piece of advice, if you're planning a visit to our city, New York, and you'd like to take this tour, my suggestion is that you make arrangements with your travel agent as soon as possible. How about that haircut? We'll be right back with the Playmate of the Year, Marianne Gravatte.
Some insurance companies send you for three estimates on a fender bender.
Gonna need new bumper, gonna need new fender, gonna need new panel,
gonna need new panel,
gonna need new bumper, gonna need new fender,
gonna need a new fender,
gonna need a new panel,
gonna need a new bumper.
Allstate Update. Claim service the easy way.
The good hands people won't send you shopping for estimates. One stop at any Allstate Claim Center can get you an estimate and a fair settlement. Right here. Without the runaround. You're in good hands with Allstate.
When Clairol created a hair setter to take care of your hair, we didn't stop with our easy wind-up rims. We didn't stop with our exclusive heat-holding corer. We didn't stop until we created a velvety roller that prevents tangling to leave hair in beautifully smooth condition. We didn't stop until we created Care Setting. Clairol Custom Care Setter. Now there's a care setter with smaller rollers. Clairol Custom Care Setter for tighter curls.
Announcing the Alpo Lucky Dog Super Game. Your chance to win one of more than 1,000 Commodore personal computers. How do you play? Just give your dog the food dogs love. Look for any specially marked cans of Alpo, bags of Alpo Dry, and boxes of Livisnaps treats, and play the Alpo Lucky Dog Super Game. Your chance to win a Commodore computer for your home. Look for these specially marked Alpo products in your store now.
Here we go. Hang on to something. According to the spread in this new issue of Playboy magazine, my next guest thinks honesty is the most important thing in a relationship. She has always wanted to go to Australia, and she says that she is very domestic when she has the time. Please welcome, ladies and gentlemen, the Playmate of the Year, Marianne Gravatte. Why did you give Bob Rooney flowers?
I was afraid you were going to ask me that.
Do you even know that guy?
No.
You just gave him the flowers?
Mm-hmm.
Well, that was a very nice gesture on your part. Now, let's get right down to it, Marianne. Congratulations, first of all. Now, are you dating Hugh Hefner? Is that
no.
part of the deal here?
No.
Do you know him at all?
I've met him.
Yeah. What happened when you met him?
We just talked.
Yeah. Then tell us about the competition. How did you get to be Playmate of the Year? What month were you?
October.
Uh-huh. And then how did you get to be the winner?
He picked me.
He picked you.
Yeah.
Then is there anything else to the competition besides that?
Well, I just did my best on promotions and did a lot of work.
Now, I wanted to... Where I was looking at some pictures here. What do you win for being Playmate of the Year?
I'm gonna receive a 928S Porsche.
Uh-huh.
And a check for $100,000.
$100,000. Now let me just. This is something that's now for example this. Look at this. Isn't it comfortable to have sand there?
My idea.
No, but that's just sticky and awful, isn't it, I would guess. Now, what about your parents, Marianne? They've seen these pictures, haven't they?
My mother has. I don't think my dad has.
Don't think them. Dad has seen them.
No.
Now, they don't mind? Your mom?
No, she liked my first one better. She thought this was a little wild.
Yeah.
Compared to the other.
Yeah. Well, that's...
But she didn't disapprove.
No, it didn't disapprove. And what do you hope to do now that you're the... What's next for you?
Well, while I'm in New York, I'll be promoting the 30th anniversary Playmate search.
Uh-huh. We don't
She's
know where
at the Drake Hotel. They're having interviews till Friday, possibly Saturday.
They're looking for the first...
The 30th anniversary Playmate.
Uh-huh. They don't know where she
next
is?
Next year. No, haven't found her yet.
Yeah. Well, this is a photograph here of the... Is that one? And then there's this one. There you go. Yep.
This is the first issue that they've put a poster in.
Yeah, that's very nice. Now, what about you have a boyfriend, I guess, huh?
Yes.
Now, how does he feel about you showing up in this magazine? You got nothing on in there, by the way.
He wasn't happy about it, but he's been very supportive of me doing it.
And what does he do for a living?
He's always been in construction. He's changed from different...
Now, would the guys that he works with give him trouble about his girlfriend being in the Playmate of the Year, do you think?
Possibly, when I'm not around. Not when I'm around, I never say anything.
But as far as you know, everything's okay there.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
So.
Now, in the article, it said that you actually cause traffic accidents when you appear out in public. Is that true?
It did happen once.
how exactly did that happen?
I was driving and... A guy on a motorcycle came up beside me, and he was trying to talk, and I wasn't talking to him, and he wasn't watching where he was going.
Yeah.
And the car in front of him had stopped, so he rear-ended him.
Yeah.
And then his friend behind him hit him.
That's too bad. Now, what do you want? Are you going to be an actress? You're going to retire, or what?
Continue modeling.
Uh-huh.
Acting. As soon as I take some acting lessons.
Yeah. We have to go away. We'll be right back.
I'm a chauffeur. It's up to me to take care of the cars I drive. Armor All Protectant, my secret. I use it on the tires, the vinyl top, and inside on the dashboard and the seats. It helps keep things like new, even on this old classy. I do hope the master never sells her. They just don't make cars like they used to. Armor All. It's science, but it works like magic.
Something Wicked This Way Comes. Rated PG. Opens tomorrow at a theater near you. Check local listings.
Your better Buick dealers are about to make those front-wheel drive imports take a back seat. With three front-wheel drive Buicks and a price under $7,000. For sporty car lovers, there's Buick's racy Skyhawk. For economy and comfort, there's the roomy Buick Skylark. And for sleek luxury, there's Buick's little limousine, Century. Now you can enter the world of front-wheel drive for as little as $69.58 at your Chicagoland, Northern Indiana Better Buick dealer.
Turn up your volume for Flashdance. The hottest movie in America. The hottest music in America. The hottest dancing in America. And the hottest romance. Flashdance. You can have it all. The excitement, the music, the energy... The fun of it all. Flashdance. Rated R.
See Flashdance, now showing at a theater near you.
Thank you, folks. Good night. We'll see you tomorrow. Tomorrow night, a special late-night salute to decreasing OPEC prices with SCTV's Martin Short, Jane Curtin, and Stupid Petrick. So fill up your tanks and watch. You bet.
Lily Tomlin shows her stuff when she hosts this week's Saturday Night Live.
Who's better qualified?
It's big time comedy, so join the in crowd.
Deliciously lean Armor bacon. The 1 pound package, just $1.49.
That's a Zerta Saver this week.
Lady, for so many years I thought I'd never find you. You have come into my life and made me whole. You're the love of my life, you're my lady.
Experience Lady Perfume and Cologne by Jovan. Now with any purchase, this Lady Perfume spray and tote, a $28.50 value, is only $10.
Presenting the ABCs of saving money. A is for AMC Spirits and four-wheel drive SX4s. Save an instant $1,000. A is for AMC Concords and four-wheel drive Eagles. Save an instant $1,500. J is for Jeep. Get a free soft top with any CJ or Scrambler. R is for Renault. An instant $800 off list on LeCar and instant $1,000 off 18 eyes. R is for Renault Alliance at $56.95 and Renault Turbo Fuego with 9.9% annual percentage rate financing available. Save money now at your AMC Jeep Renault dealers while it's as easy as ABC.
Channel 5 News covers the inauguration of Harold Washington live Friday at 2.
That you cannot please all of the people, even some of the time, is not news. But it's always good for a headline.
So too, it seems, bizarre business dealings, coming out from under the bed to sing your song, or eating the mail. And that's the menu for another sitting of Overnight.
The result of rhetoric is more rhetoric.